This Yankees team, meanwhile, has the best record in baseball, tied with the Dodgers. What is most surprising, EK, about this year's Yankees?
I mean, there's a lot of things, but I think collectively, if you were to tell me that Stanton and Judge would have a combined 13 home runs, Severino hasn't pitched an inning, and the Yankees have the best record in baseball, I would have said, you're nuts.
You're crazy.
You're absolutely crazy. But that's exactly what happened. You know, look at Stanton and Stanton and Judge, they average 40 home runs, 100 RBIs a year. Severino, his last two seasons, I mean, he's averaging about 17 wins. There's been none of that. Yet the Yankees have just continued to dominate. It's like they haven't even missed a step. It's almost like they've been better without these guys, which is crazy.
Is that a testament to Aaron Boone?
It is, and I'll tell you this. When you lose your stars, you realize that there's probably going to be a regression. They won 100 games last year, but I think Aaron Boone's doing a better job this year managing all of those problems that he's had, especially at the beginning of the year. What you do, you have guys that step up, and Gio Urshela has stepped up. If you look at his career, in his small career, listen, he was hitting .225 his first year in Cleveland, .224 the next year, and then you start going over to Toronto. He comes over to the Yankees as a surplus, and he shows up .335, 18 home runs, 64 RBI, and he has a career year at the perfect time. But also, you have to have the ability as a manager to put people in successful positions. I think Aaron Boone has done a fabulous job doing that. But his roster construction was blown up when you lose your stars at the beginning of the year. And they have not missed a beat. They're actually a better team, I think, than they were last year.
Yeah, you know, the thing is, there's got to be an element of luck. And there's been a lot of luck over there. When you talk about the bad luck, you say, oh, yeah, well, these guys have been hurt. But you know, you just mentioned Urshela, Talkman as well.
Talkman. You know, .394 since July 1st.
Right. I mean, he's been unbelievable as well. And these are guys that really didn't get opportunities elsewhere. And look, if anybody was going to tell you, oh, yeah, well, I knew Urshela was going to hit, then I'd have called them lying. Maybe catch a ball, but I don't know about the hitting part. And then even, you could even say, you know, DJ LeMahieu has been arguably the best free agent sign. He's come over and hasn't missed it. He's been better. He has been better for the Yankees than he was when he won batting titles for the Rockies. I mean, that's just a fact. I mean, so there is that luck element.
My biggest surprise concerning the Yankees is the fact that the Red Sox are 17 and a half games behind the Yankees on August 14th. If you would have told me that at the beginning of the season, I wouldn't have believed you.
Yeah, I would have taken that bet, too.
Exactly. So they have shut down Jake Arrieta. Sweeney, are the postseason hopes for the Phillies done with Jake Arrieta being shut down?
I don't think you can ever say done, especially in the National League. I don't think anyone is done. There's a first tier and then a second tier in teams, and I believe. And I think the Phillies fit into that category.
Second
tier. And when you start losing guys like that, I think it's the next man up. Another opportunity for these young starters. Nick Pivetta might get that opportunity. Zach Eflin might get that opportunity. But this is really one of those things that you have to step up. You have to have the ability to go out there and man that position. And I think the Philadelphia Phillies are going to expect that.
Yeah, you know, look, Jake Arrieta wasn't, as Gabe said, really giving them an opportunity to win. You know, he was taxing the bullpen. He wasn't able to go deep. He had a real rough one against San Francisco. And so, you know, now you move Zach Eflin, or as you mentioned, Pivetta. These guys have been in the bullpen. That's not where they're suited. And Gabe Kapler has been kind of, you know, his hands have been tied. You know, I use these guys and I can't use them for a few days because their starters are getting acclimated to the bullpen. Now you put them in the rotation where they would much rather be to begin with. And then, again, the pitching staff isn't going to be what gets them to the postseason. They've got to be okay. It's going to be the offense. The offense is going to have to get going. They're going to have to hit their way to the postseason. You saw Harper. You see Hoskins. Real Muto. Charlie Manuel. That's the magic potion.
Yeah, and you know what? Charlie Manuel will give them really an uptick. You think about it. Jim Thome's always said that's his passion, to be able to talk about hitting, to have the connection that you have with hitters. Even though he managed there before, and that's a different dynamic, he's been in touch with this organization for a long time. So he knows the players, knows what's going to take. But really, what it comes down to, Bryce Harper has to be the MVP version, the 2015 version, for this offense to go off. And that's going to help the pitching.
But we pretty much, I know you guys agree that the Nats and the Braves you see as playoff teams. You think three teams make it from the NL East? The Phillies get in?
So I don't know. Well, I shouldn't say I think they get him, but it's not inconceivable. I don't see anybody. I do see the Braves and the Nationals getting in. And then whoever wins the Central, they automatically get to go in, right? And that, I mean, I would say the Cardinals probably have the best chance of winning that division. I don't know that somebody else comes out of there. I could see the Phillies getting hot. Again, that offense, it has the ability to dominate. Whether they do it or not, we'll find out.
Right. Yeah, I think there's a lot of parity when you think about that. But also, every week it's going to change. You're going to see a hot team and go, well, they have the best opportunity. But that's going to change week to week. There's a lot of baseball left.
Do you call it parity or mediocrity?
Both.
Like, I mean, seriously. Yeah, like,
it's how you look at it. I mean, it seems like if the three teams go in from the National League East, then I think that's parity. That's not mediocrity if you have three playoff teams.
It's mediocrity in the, it's mediocrity
across the National League.
I think you have the Dodgers, you have the Nationals, and you have the Braves.
Then there's a drop-off.
And then it's just like, I mean, whoever is playing well at the end of the year, that's who's going to get in.